Boston, CBS. What began as an injury accident investigation in Hyde Park Thursday afternoon has led to a pair of businesses in that area being shut down for various code violations. Boston police said they received a call around 12:40 p.m. Thursday for a person struck by a motor vehicle at 1192 Hyde Park Avenue. C&V Automotive is located at that address and is a leased garage for the purpose of auto repair. Emergency medical and fire personnel, attending to a male victim, were already on scene when officers arrived. The victim told police he was standing behind the vehicle when it accelerated backwards and hit him. The man was taken to the hospital, where he is in stable condition. Following the accident, inspectional services and the Boston Public Health Commission were called to the scene and discovered several health, fire safety and building code violations, including raw sewage in the basement, hazardous materials and structural problems. According to inspectional services documents, the property in question extends from 1182 Hyde Park Avenue to 1196 Hyde Park Avenue and is owned by the DeSangro Family Trust of Roslindale. Investigators say owner Dan DeSangro turned a blind eye to conditions on his property. Nobody complaining, nobody getting on the owner, why don't you fix this? Everyone just doing what they want, John Meany of Inspectional Services told WBZ. Building code violations include retaining wall failure and exposed electrical wires. Little Haiti International Cuisine at 1184 Hyde Park Avenue was cited for having raw sewage on the basement floor, along with rodent droppings and non-restaurant-related items. Public Health Commission documents said the garage had multiple barrels of waste oil and hazardous materials without labels and did not have proper permits available to operate as an auto repair shop. Also, there is an order to have oxygen, acetylene and propane gas tanks found on the premises, along with all vehicles, removed. So the oil drums, drum after drum, just sitting there and some out in the backyard. So that has to be moved. Flammables. There was no organization. I don't even know if it was an auto shop, Meany said. The property owners were also cited for failing to obtain a permit to operate as a garage and tavern with live entertainment, along with residential quarters in the rear of the premises. DeSangro has been ordered to hire a firm that specializes in cleaning up hazardous materials before the businesses can reopen.